Hello, folks. Welcome to Lester's Custom Truck Shop. Got another brand new radio here. It's amazing what you can find in the warehouse if you just spend a little time in there. It's a Ranger Communications Incorporated, RCI, RG99. Okay, you in the box. I'm going to crack the box open and get the radio out and get some photos of it. I'll be back. Okay, in the box, there's the power cord. I wonder why that's not up here in this. And the manual. Doesn't look like the manual's ever been open. And here's the radio. That's different. Alright, I'll get it out and we'll have a look at it. Okay, got it out of the package. Nice looking radio. Looks like the old Unidun or Jackson faceplate. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 bands, all mode. Transmit and receive LED, Ranger. And this is an RCI radio, not one of the old Ranger radios made by like the 3300 to 3500. This one is made in Malaysia. It's got the standard Ranger heatsink on it. Got a place for a frequency counter. So I'm curious now to see which board it's got in it. It's kind of a weird place to put the warranty sticker. But it hasn't been broken. 4-pin microphone. I bet this thing's got a 6900 10Z board in it. What you want to bet? Alright, let me crack it open. We'll take a look. Be back. Okay. I decided to hook it up and see if the internal part of it had been adjusted yet. And you know what I mean by that. Where's the center button on that? And look at there. Channel 38. Lower sideband. It does come with an echo board built into it. Got a nice feel on the fine and coarse tune clarifier. Mic gain, RF gain, volume squelch. You know, it's got four dual control knobs. Another nice, really nice looking radio. I probably ought to put this in my collection instead of selling it. But, yeah, I got enough radios. And there's no shortage of frequencies. Let's see, that's channel 40 right there. And let's go all the way down. And what's this high-low thing here? Oh my lord. That's what the high-low does. So just how low can we go? There's one with the low out. Wow. 10 and 12 meters. Covers 10, 11, and 12 meters. Alright, let me put a microphone on it and see what it's doing. I'll be back. Okay, I can tell right away this is a dual final radio. Not only from the heat sink, but also the output. Audio. And let me crack her open. We'll have a look at that. I'll break that warranty seal. But I've got another warranty seal to go on it. It won't be just like the factory seal, but it'll be real close. Okay, let's see. Let me go back to the high band. Looks like band G. That button pushed in. Looks like band G is 11 meters. It's on channel 1 there. There's 40. And the clarifier's dead on. Amazing. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, here we are on lower side of 38. Boy, noisy. Got a good receiver on it. Let's see if we can go to upper side. I'm going to go to 555. We're on the upper side, yeah. See what we can hear up here. It's because 38 just jumped. See what we can get on the ham bands. Be something right around here. They were doing contest earlier.
You're also 5 and 9. Good luck.
Get an idea of what it's doing. Let's see. I'm gonna get somebody to answer me. Break 19 for radio check. Hello, is this radio working? It looks like it's working. Let's see. Let me turn on the monitor radio. And let's go, let's put this one on the lower side of 38. Switch back to dummy load. Switch that one to external antenna. The lower sideband. And Turn the RF gain down on this one. Hello, 1-2. Hello, 1-2. Audio, 1-2. Clarifier's off a little bit. Hello, 1-2. 1-2, hello. Oh, wait a second. Clarifier may not need to transmit. Bet it doesn't. So I'll have to adjust that. Hello, 1-2. Hello, 1-2. Audio test, test, 1-2. And that should be a little bit closer right there. Audio testing, testing, 1-2-3. 1-2-3 test. We turn the volume up a little bit so you can hear it a little better. Audio test, test, 1-2. 1-2 test. Yep, I've got to unlock the clarifier, looks like. But I'll take care of that and do the alignment. And have it aligned and set up properly and ready to go. I do that with all the radios, new radios I sell. Because most of them are not tuned right from the factory. And like this one, I can't believe that the transmit and receive RIT is, separate. I'll go in and fix that. Make the transmit match the receive. So that way when you tune somebody in to where they sound normal, you will sound normal to them. All right, I'll be back. Okay, just like I thought, this is the Ranger RG99. It is an EPT6910Z board by Ranger. I like this board. It is the dual final version. Those are bipolar transistors. I think that's a 2166 driver and two 2312s. So, if you VSWR goes a little high, you ain't got to worry about it blowing the finals right away like you do on the FET radios. That is a small 1000 microfarad cap. And I'm going to do just like I did on the VXs. The other one is up underneath this one. But I'm pretty sure it's a 1000 also. I'll get in there and replace these two. And the AMC and ALC, I've already adjusted those. Output power on this radio is about 25 or 30 watts. Nice board. Nice radio. This one's going to go for a little more than what the VX68s are, because it has 12 bands and the VX68s have 6. But we do sell the switch for the VX68s, the 6 position switch that'll give it 12 bands, just like this one has if you want it. We sell those for $50 installed. And I should have put that on the VX68 video, but I forgot to. Might go back and add that. But that's what it looks like inside. Okay, we'll be back. Okay, I've got the bigger capacitors soldered in. I don't know if you can see that one. Yeah, you can just barely see that one. Replace the two smaller 1000 microfarad 25 volt caps, and getting ready to do the alignment on it and be boxing her back up. Okay, I'll be back. Just finished the alignment after letting it sit here and warm up for a little while. That is low range. That is high range. Now, it was spot on. Oh, I know what it is. I got the covers off of it. I better leave it alone. I'll touch it up just a tap. Oh, man. All you got to do is breathe on it. Okay. All right. Low band.
high band. Upper side band, lower side band. Low band. Upper side band. I'm sorry, that's low side band. Okay. Upper side band. AM. Okay. High band. AM. Upper side. Lower side. Okay. Spot on. All right. Let's see. What else did I need to do to this thing? I think that was it. Just do the alignment. And you guys know that you can see that I'm using an FC390, and you're going, well, that's not accurate. Well, normally they wouldn't be. What I do is I calibrate it using my Tektronix CFC250, which has been calibrated. And yeah, I do have to calibrate it about once a month, but it's pretty doggone accurate. You know, but it does vary. I mean, as it gets older, the crystal gets older, the reference oscillator gets older, and it does vary. But I've added things to this particular counter to stabilize it and make it not drift as much. In other words, the 4 megahertz reference oscillator that they use in these things for the to determine the frequency, I have replaced the one that was in there with one that's a much higher stability crystal. Instead of plus or minus 100 parts per million, the one I've got in there is plus or minus 25 parts per million. You know, it's much more accurate than what the normal counter is. And plus, like I say, I use my CFC250 to calibrate it, and I calibrate this the CFC250 off of the 10 or 15 megahertz signal from WWV. So they're accurate, and well, actually, I tested the CFC250 using my contraption there in the WWV signal. I actually have a lab here that calibrates instruments for the Navy. A friend of mine works there, and he checks them for me. But this is a nice radio. Whoever gets it, you're going to enjoy it. Okay, thanks for watching.